smart efficient. Today we have one of the person that is behind this concert, and is Neill George. Neill, tell us about yourself.
Hi, Rebecca. I've been working in events now in London for about 7 years, and recently had the good fortune of meeting David. Mutual friend of mine and David's that contacted me from Paris to say that he was here for the 100-year anniversary of the French Institute. David was the headline for that, so as a person that's been promoting nightclubs for a long time, I was actually asked to promote this as a concert involving David.
That's fantastic, but I hear that you're also member of a different kind of society. Tell me a little bit about that.
This is London Society Events. It's something that a friend, Fabian Piekowski, and I set up 7 years ago. And that was really an offshoot of all the social networking websites which have occurred around London and the globe. And what we did was bring together a lot of the people from these sites and brought them into one events platform in London.
And what? Tell me about your next event, so people can know and can attend, and how to contact you.
Okay, well, our next event, actually, we're arranging a James Bond brunch party, which is at a secret location, our own MI6 headquarters in London. And we will actually be featuring Angela, who you've met also this evening, the lady performing with David. She'll be singing some of the Bond theme tunes, and also a couple of other friends and singers that I know will be there performing.
Okay, and when is, what date is that, or is it a secret yet?
No, that I can give away, actually. It's the 27th, which is the day after the premiere of Skyfall on the 26th.
Fantastic. So, can you tell me your website?
We don't operate through a website.
Okay.
So we keep it very exclusive by just email only and personal contact with people.
Okay. So if someone wants to contact you personally, how can they do that?
Well, I suppose through friends or friends' friends.
So you can Google him. His name is Neill George, and he's from the London Society. So thank you so much for inviting us today.
And a privilege it is for you to hear me here tonight. I can't mention any names because it would be wrong of me to do so. But all this crap that's appearing in the newspapers about Jimmy Savile, please don't insult what little intelligence I have by telling me that we all knew what a lovely fellow Jim was. Jim fixed it for so many young children who are out there. Why didn't all this come out before? Now I could, but I'm not going to. Why should I? Because I'm not at the moment that well known. If only I were well known. There are at least four other names I'd like to mention. A comic, now I can name him, can't I? But I won't bother because he never publicises me, so I won't publicise him. Not so long ago, 1988, telling people, and it's been filmed, what kind of man Jimmy Savile really was. And what does he say? Fuck the lot of you, I'm dead. Take his knighthood away. I ask you, what kind of world do we live in? We all know we've got the best Prime Minister we could ever have. And I say that, you can look at me, madam, when I ask you that question. He is beyond any shadow of a doubt the best Prime Minister the country's ever had and will like and ever be liked because, like me, he dares to tell the truth. Thank you very much. I must go now because I can see a hand beckoning. I do hope you've enjoyed the few words of wisdom that I've had spared with you. The thing is, so many comics feel that they have to work from a script. That is, of course, unless you are as intelligent as Stephen Fry, but then nobody else is. Ubiquitous? Oh, stop it. The doctor said to me, you've got 3 months to live. And what did I say? One thing, doctor, that pleases me is that never again will I have to see Stephen Fry's face or hear his voice. Not to say that he isn't any good. Not to say that he isn't a nice man. But when you see someone just so much, after a while you start to think, how much more? Is it his fault? Whose fault is it? Good night.